गुड आफ्टरनून मैम. सो एज अ पार्ट ऑफ माई क्लिनिकल पोस्टिंग एंड सो आई हैव पोस्टेड इन द रेनबो हॉस्पिटल एंड साइकियाट्रिक वार्ड. सो आई टुक अ केस प्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ मिस्टर सुरेश, 46 ईयर्स ऑफ एज. ही वॉज एडमिटेड ऑन 23rd February. सो विद द चीफ कंप्लेंट्स ऑफ एलिवेटेड और इरिटेबल मूड, फ्लाइट ऑफ आइडियाज, डिल्यूशन ऑफ ग्रैंडियर एंड इंक्रीज सोशलबिलिटी. सो बाय दिस द डॉक्टर डायग्नोस इट एज अ मैनिया. सो हैज़ अ केस प्रेजेंटेशन एंड आई हैव टेकन दिस मैनिया केस हैज़ माई केस प्रेजेंटेशन. सो कमिंग टू द हिस्ट्री कलेक्शन एंड द पेशेंट प्रोफाइल, हिज नेम इज मिस्टर सुरेश. सो ही इज 46 ईयर्स ऑफ एज एंड इज अ मेल एंड ही आर डायग्नोज्ड एज अ मैनिया. सो वेन ही वॉज एडमिटेड एंड ऑन 23rd February ही वॉज एडमिटेड इन द हॉस्पिटल विद एलिवेटेड सिम्टम्स. And coming to the chief complaints, and according to the client is explained that so he is having a irritable mood and hypersexual behavior here, and decreased attention towards other person and concentration is lacking. The pressure of speech is also is increased mood. So that the client has been explained, and according to the informant, that is his wife. So he explained that elevated mood and flight of ideas, so delusion of grandeur and impulsive behavior. So these are the symptoms and said by his wife. And coming to the present history, the time of onset of illness was started on 23rd February at 11 PM. It was started. So the symptoms like a chief complaints what they have explained. So the reason of hospitalization is that due to the elevated signs and symptoms only they have admitted in a hospital, and duration of illness from 10 days before. So these elevated of symptoms they have been explained. So coming to the medical and surgical history and the nil significance of medical and surgical history they have identified. So coming to the present psychiatric history, and Mr. Suresh was admitted in psychiatric hospital on 23rd February 2020, so with the precipitating factor of stress. And the informant and the patient given complaints that irritable mood, flight of ideas, pressure of speech and hypersexual activity and hyperactivity. So the doctor diagnosed, and according to the category of ICD-10 criteria, and diagnosed as a mania. And now he is taking a treatment of lithium and 900 mg per day they are taking, and carbamazepine 600 mg per day and sodium valproate. So these three drugs they are taking as a present psychiatric history. And coming to the past psychiatric history, so Mr. Suresh is suffering with a mania from 10 days before with the precipitating factor of the stress in his occupation and the financial problem. So he himself arised with certain symptoms of mania and has elevated and admitted the hospital with the chief complaints of elevated mood, hyperactivity. So doctor diagnosed as a mania and taking a treatment of lithium, carbamazepine and the sodium valproate he is taking. And coming to the family history, and he has a Mr. Suresh, the 46 years of age is a patient. And Mrs. Sunita is wife, and Miss Anita is a daughter. And Mr. Suresh family members not have any type of communicable diseases like tuberculosis, malaria or some other etc. So only Suresh is suffering with some other conditions like mania, psychiatric disorder. And next is the personal history. So in the personal history, so the person is lacking with the sleep, and due to the hyperactivity and exercises, he is not doing any type of exercises. And appetite is lack of appetite, diet pattern is one time per day he is eating. And our relationship with the friends is a hyper sociability we can see. So habits like under talking with others and spending a lot of time we can see. And dressing like hyperactivity, dressing means grandeur, dressing in a so gaudy like that they have observed. And personality like hyperactivity personality they have observed, and relationship with the others are the hyper sociability relationship. And next one is the socioeconomic history. So the family monthly income is 12,000, and only Mr. Suresh is a father of the nothing is a breadwinner of the family, and he is the source of income by the teacher. And financial status is well better. So but after this, the financial status is well depressed. So due to that financial status only, so he has attempted the disorder of the mania. and he has all the facilities like so presence of ventilation and electricity, drainage and hospital facilities, and also markets, temples and everything. They are nearby and the best facilities. And the prenatal history like and her mother undergone good immunization and ready. She did not expose any type of immunization, and she underwent a normal delivery at 3 kgs of birth weight, and no abnormalities of postnatal, and given a breast milk. And childhood history like the patient went on half an hour of delivery, she initiated a breast milk, and age of weaning is 6 months of age of weaning, and no any other subtype of maternal deprivation has been observed. The toilet training has been at the 16th month of the year. Coming to the play history and the childhood, indoor and outdoor games has been very enthusiasm, and peer relationship is very good, and education is good in academics, and he's a good teacher. And coming to the occupation history, he's a 24 years, he started a job occupation, and job satisfaction is good at certain period, and at present with the financial status, and he is not satisfied with the salary. And coming to the sexual and marital history, is good in relationship with the sexual, his wife and the partner. And coming to the premorbid personality, like interpersonal relationship is maintained and leisure time, and he was major spend at the time with the students, and a predominant mood like hyperactivity, mood elevated and hypersexual behavior we can see here in the predominant mood. And attitude towards the self and others before the condition is good, and after the condition, and like impulsive behavior, increased sociability and absent of insight. So these kind of characteristics he has observed. And fantasy life, speaking and spending time with students and the friends is fantasy life. And habits like he is fond of reading books. And coming to and next to the physical examination, and like general appearance, and he is a dull in hyperactivity in conscience, and his dressing capability is very dirty, and vital signs are normal. And coming to the integumentary system, and the dryness of the skin texture we have observed, and also the genitourinary system like abnormal polyuria is there, and that we have observed, and due to the excess hyperactivity. And some in the neurological examination, mood elevated and hyperactivity observed, and overactivity, memory is good but maintain a good body balances. Okay, that you have seen here. And coming next is a mental status examination. So in the mental status examination, so the gait and posture is abnormal, and physical appearance is overactivity is there, and attitude towards examiner is very hyperactive, and also disinterested, and he is not listening towards the examiner but showing often as though he is active towards the examiner. And motor activity is very overactivity we can see, and more increased verbal response is also, more rapport is also increased with the every person, and he don't have any type of hallucinatory behaviors. And coming to the speech and high communication, and volume tone of speech, high pitch of voice, and hyperactive rhythm of speech is observed here. And coming to speech and is observed, and mood and effect. So I asked, and how are you feeling now, and he has given a over response that yes, I am super. Okay, so these kind of information and given, so but as per the mood and effect, okay, so is observed that, so the patient is impaired. And coming to the perception, okay, so you don't have any hallucination behaviors or illusion and misinterpretations, but and he is depersonal and derealization, so he is not realized to the situation, so whatever is happening. And next one is the somatic passivity phenomenon. So whatever the answer is that, so he is saying that you don't have any problem, so you don't have conscious towards his condition also. And thought process, so his thought process is fluctuating, and he has a hyperactive behavior, and what he is speaking also is not conscious towards his mind. And next one, content thoughts like delusion of grandeur he is having. Okay, and coming to the coordination, and he is well oriented to time, place and the person he is maintaining, and attention is good, and concentration is also good. So concentration is also good because he's a good teacher. And coming to the memory and giving a response of immediate, recent and remote memory is good. And intelligence is giving a good response, and abstract thinking like proverb testing as a question, and he given a good response. And coming to similarities and difference between ticks and lice has given an answer. And coming to the insight, and do you have any physical problem, I asked. No, I don't have any problem, he said. So but the person is having of the insight problem. The insight is impaired. So means he don't have the conscious regarding his insight. And the next one is a judgment. So he can't able to have a judge towards the personal as well as a society also. He can't able to judge because he himself is not going to be judge himself. So the investigations they are performing, like ICD-10 criteria they have done, and mania rating scale, whenever we have done, increased elevated mood we have observed, and based on the signs and symptoms, and they have observed the showing of signs and symptoms like elevated mood and hyperactivity, sexual behavior, and so delusion of grandeur. So these types of clinical manifestations or signs and symptoms they have observed. So medication like lithium they have given, so 600 mg orally, like OD morning they have given this one, and this lithium is going to be stabilize the mood of the person. And side effects like increased thirst, increased urination and diarrhea, vomiting, weight gain, we have observed the side effects of this lithium drug. And renal failure as a contraindication, and cardiovascular deficiency and Addison's disease is a contraindication in the medication. And coming to the disease condition, so this man, yeah, already discussed that features of overactivity, mood changes and the self-important ideas is called as a mania. So the etiological factor of this patient is a psychodynamic theory, means the stress factors only is essential for the etiological factor. And clinical manifestation, the patient is having like elevated expansive mood, psychomotor activity, speech and thought disturbance is there, increased sociability, impulsive behavior and hypersexual behavior we have observed. And the diagnosis like psychological test like mania rating scale and ICD-10 diagnostic criteria, and based on signs and symptoms they have done a diagnosis. And treatment like pharmacological therapy like lithium, carbamazepam and sodium valproate, so they have given, and ECT also they have performed. And some of the psychosocial therapy like family therapy and the marital therapy they have underwent. And coming to the nursing management, so they have assessed the severity of disorder, and also assess the patient judgment, and relevant data should be collected and assessed everything, the mood and affect, thinking and perceptual activity, everything assessment done by me. And also nursing diagnosis have done, that is a high risk form of injury related to extreme hyperactivity and impulsive behavior, so as evidenced by lack of control. And high risk for violence related to manic excitement, delusion, thinking and hallucinations. And altered nutrition is there, less than the body requirement, so related to refusal or inability to sit still long enough to eat, so evidenced by the weight loss. So that I have observed in this diagnosis. So some of the interventions I also have planned. So that is the case. And process recording like, and what are the questions I asked, and the patient is giving hyperactivity questions, and the therapeutic technique and they have performed is a behavior therapy and the family and individual therapy they have done. And a diet plan, that is morning upma we have given, and afternoon rice with the dal curry we have